may be seated. Dearly beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together Heather and Brent in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and His church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with His presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If marriage is to last for a lifetime, it must be built upon love. In the 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians, the Apostle Paul gives a beautiful description of the type of love it takes to build a happy home. Paul writes, "Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am a sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have enough faith so that I can remove mountains, but if I have not love, I am nothing. And though I give all my possessions to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, if I have not love, it profits me nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy. Love does not brag. Love is not arrogant. Love does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends." Will you bow your heads as we pray together? Our Father, we thank you for the love of these families, a love that has strengthened and secured the affection that Heather and Brent have for each other. I pray that you will grant an unselfish love to them now as they stand before you in this act of commitment to each other. I pray their love for each other will grow stronger with the passing years. Give them love and grace so they can forgive each other during those turbulent times that are inevitable in any relationship. I pray that you will also grant to them the gift of celebration so they can enjoy the many happy times they will share together as husband and wife. But most of all, I pray that you will always keep their attention focused upon you. For you are the author and perfecter of every good gift of love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Heather and Brent, I require and charge you as you stand in the presence of God, that having duly considered the holy covenant you're about to make, you do now declare before this company your pledge of faith each to the other. Be well assured, if you keep these vows as God's word demands, God will bless your marriage, will grant you fulfillment in it, and will establish your home in peace. Brent, will you have Heather to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep her only unto you so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Heather, will you have Brent to be your wedded husband to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep him only unto you so long as you both shall live?
I will and I do.
Okay. Got both bases covered on that. Who presents Heather to be married to Brent?
Mother and her father.
Thank you so much. You may now be seated. And Heather, if you would step up, please. And while you're doing that, if you would turn in your hymnal to number 529. You'll find the number in your bulletin. We'll do verses 1 and 5 of How Firm a Foundation. Thank you. And now a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verses 1 through 9. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to gain and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. And may God add His blessing to this reading from His Word. And now, Heather, if you and Brent would face each other and looking into each other's eyes, Brent, if you would repeat after me, please. I, Brent.
Take thee, Heather.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. And I pledge to you my faith. Okay, Heather, if you would repeat after me, please. I, Heather.
Take thee, Brent.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. And I pledge to you my faith.
Okay.
Thank you. These wedding rings are outward and visible signs of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Brent and Heather in holy matrimony through the Church of Jesus Christ our Lord. Will you bow your heads as I pray God's blessing upon the rings? Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in your peace and continue in your favor through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And repeat after me, please. In token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, Heather, if you would slip that on Brent's finger. And repeat after me, in token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, let me have both of your hands in my hand. For as much as Heather and Brent have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce their husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God hath joined together, let no one put asunder. And now Misty will sing, God Will Take Care of You.
Be not dismayed, whatever betide, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. God will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you. No matter what may be the test, God will take care of you. Lean weary one upon his breast, God will take care of you. God will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you.
Thank you, Misty, and what a wonderful truth to build a marriage upon and to provide the direction for your lives. In Ruth chapter 1, verses 16 and 17, we find these very appropriate words. But Ruth said, don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. And again, may God add his blessing to this reading from his word. And now may God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord graciously with his favor look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and love, that you may so live together in this life, so that in the world to come you may have life everlasting. Amen. And you may now kiss your bride. And ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brent Adam Catchings.
Thank you.
We wish to remind you there is a hospitality room from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock at the Courtyard Marriott, and then the reception will be held at 5 o'clock at the Jewel Collins Smith Museum. You are now dismissed.